Okay, so a good question would be, well, how do we solve a triangle when it's not a right triangle? So first of all, we have some terminology for that. We're dealing with what are called oblique triangles. So in math, when we talk about an oblique triangle, all we mean is that there's not a right angle. That is, none of the angles is 90 degrees. So if you don't have a right angle, you need some information. Now, the possible information you could have would be classified in the following ways. Let me first write these down, and I'll explain what they mean. So AAS is one possibility. ASA, SSA, SSS, and SAS. Okay, so the letter S stands for side of a triangle and A stands for angle. And if you see a letter between, like the S is between two A's, that's telling you that you have angle side angle with the side between two angles. So for example, with this triangle here, somebody might give you the angle, the side, and then the angle. Do you see how the side is between the two angles? That's what we mean by angle side angle. But if somebody writes this, that they give you angle angle side, then the side is not between the two angles. That might look like this: angle, angle, and then side. Okay? So you have to see what kind of information you're given to be able to solve your triangle. Now it turns out for the first three, we can solve using law of sines. And we'll do that in this video. Law of sines. And in another video, we're going to solve these two cases using law of cosines. Okay, now it turns out that you might notice in this list that there is no AAA, angle, angle, angle. And the reason is because simply because you know all the angles of a triangle doesn't mean that you've determined what the sides have to be. So angle, 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 you'll never be able to determine that triangle specifically. Okay, so law of sines, what is it? Let's look at this triangle. Angles are denoted with capital letters. So let's call that capital A, this capital B, and this angle capital C. Now the sides opposite the angles are denoted with lowercase letters, like a lowercase a, a lowercase b, and a lowercase c. What law of sine says is this, that sine of the angle big A divided by little a is equal to sine of any of the other angles divided by its corresponding side. So this is equal to sine of, for example, big B divided by little b. But it's also equal to sine of big C divided by little c. And this is law of sines. Now we're going to use law of sines, like I was mentioning, in the first three cases. So let's go ahead and see an example of that now. Let's solve this triangle. And so what case are we in? Well, this would be angle side angle. And I can see that because I have this side between the two angles. Now, I like to write down all the information that's easy right in the beginning. So if these two angles are given like this, then clearly I can find the third angle, right? These angles had to be 135, which means this angle's got to be 135, 45 degrees, because you have to add to be 180. Okay? Now I can use the law of sines to find these sides. Let's call this side, how about this side, call it B, and let's call this side side C. So I can see that sine of 45 degrees divided by 20, right, because it's the side opposite 45 degrees, is equal to sine of 110 divided by B. So if I solve this equation for B, I'm going to cross multiply, so B times sine of 45 degrees is equal to 20 times sine of 110, divide both sides by sine of 45. And on my calculator, I find that B is equal to, or about equal to, meaning this is an approximation, 26.58. Okay, and this is a length, it's not degrees because it's the length of this side. Okay, and likewise, we can find C, right? It's also true that sine of 45 degrees divided by 20. Oops. Divided by 20 is equal to sine of 25 degrees right, divided by C, right? I chose 25 degrees because it's the angle opposite the side C. And then likewise, I get C sine of 45 degrees is equal to 20 sine of 25 degrees. And so divide both sides by sine of 45. And I get C is about equal to 11.95. Okay, so these would be my values. Now I solved this triangle, meaning that I found all the angles and all the sides. And notice that A was given, right? Okay, let's try another one like that. Okay, so this deals with a situation that's it's side-side angle. Now, side-side angle is called the ambiguous case. First of all, do you see why it's side-side angle? Because it's side-side, and the angle is not between the two sides. Right? If the angle is over here, that would be side-angle side. We don't have that. We have side-side, and then an angle that's not between the two sides. Okay, now when we say the ambiguous case, the reason we call it that is because you could either have no solution, no such triangle with the information you're given. You could have one solution, or you can even have two triangles that satisfy all those conditions. Let's go ahead and use law of sines on this one. So I see that sine of 120 divided by 30 is equal to, let's call, how about this angle, angle A, is equal to sine of A divided by 20. Okay? So cross multiply, 30 times sine of A is 20 times sine of 120. So divide both sides now by 30. And I get sine of A is equal to, well, it's going to be on my calculator 0.577. Now, I'm going to use the inverse sine button on my calculator, and I'm going to find that A is about equal to 35.3 degrees. Now, you have to be really careful here because your calculator. All inverse sine is going to do is give you an angle between zero or make that negative 90 degrees and positive 90 degrees. Now we know, generally speaking, that angles can be anywhere between 0 and 180. Okay? So if I go up here and I say, oh, what does 35.3 degrees look like? That would be like maybe right here, right? This is 35.3. Do you see another angle between 0 and 180 that has the same value of sine? Sure, because sine just focuses on the y coordinate, right? And these two points have the same y coordinate. So this angle gives the same value of sine. The question is what's that angle? Well, these two triangles are congruent, so this angle is 35.3 as well, just from right there. Okay? So this angle all the way around, that would be the angle, what would it be? 144.7. 144.7. How did I get that? Well, because I knew I took 180 and I subtracted 35.3. So this angle is 144.7. So let me write that down. Or is A equal, can A be equal to 144.7? 144.7 degrees? Is that a possibility? Well, why is this not a possibility? Because if it was, look what would happen. If A was 144.7, if you added it to 120, you'd be at 264 degrees, way too much, right? You'd exceed 180. So the problem is that if A was 144.7, there'd be no room for C, right? You have to have enough left over for an angle C. So this is impossible. A cannot be 144.7. So now we'll see in another example where there could be a second possibility, but in this case, A has got to be 35.3. And what that means is that you can find what the angle, this angle has to be. Let's call this angle, I think we called it C a moment ago. Let's call that angle C, right? So what would C have to be? Well, let's see. C is going to be 180, right? Take away, well, 120, that's in the mix, right? Take away, and I got the 120 from this, take away the 35.3 that I just found, and that gives me a C of equal to, what would that be? Let's see, 24.7, is that right? 24.7. Let me see if these all add up to be 180. So add these together and you get Yeah, 60 and then 120. Yeah, so C would be 24.7. Okay, now the last thing to do, of course, would be to find, you have the two sides, right? You have the side A and you have the side B. The last thing to do would be to find this side, this little side right here, side C. And that means you can use law of sines again, because sine of 120 divided by 30 is equal to sine of C, which we just found to be 24.7 degrees, divided by little c, which is the last side we're looking for over here. So I have C sine of 120 is equal to 30 sine of 24.7. So let's see, C would be equal to 30 sine of 24.7 divided by sine of 120. And so I'm looking at a C about equal to, what would it be? Let's see here. What would this be? That would be 14.48 using my calculator. 14.48. Okay, so this would be my value for the side C. And my angle C, right? Let's box that. That was 24.7 degrees. A little degree symbol there. And the A had to be 35.3 degrees. There was no other option. So I found my A, I found my C, and I found my side C as well. Okay, so I said that this was the ambiguous case, and here I had one solution. Now let's see an example where you have two solutions. We'll do that now. Okay, so let's consider solving a triangle with the following values. So I can see that I have an angle and the side opposite the angle, so let's use law of sines. So sine of 20 degrees divided by 13 is equal to sine of B divided by its corresponding side, 30. So that's going to be, let's see, 13 sine of B is 30 times sine of 20. And then sine of B is equal to, well, 30 sine of 20 divided by 13. So I get, let's see, sine of B is, what would that be? Equal to 0.79 using my calculator. And so that means B is about equal to 52.11 degrees. Now, how did I get that 52.11? I took inverse sine, right? And the calculator said, oh, 52.11. But remember, the calculator always, inverse sine always gives me an angle between negative 90 and positive 90. So it gave me this angle right here, 52.11. Let's draw that in, maybe like this. Okay. Now there's another angle that has the same value of sine, and that would be over here. That is the angle with the same y coordinate. So that would be this angle. Let's draw that in like so. Okay. So if this is 52.11, the question is, what's that angle? Well, this triangle, right? If this is 52.11, this angle right here is 52.11. Okay, and that means this angle, that is the other angle with the same value of sine, that angle would be, well, 180 take away 52.11, which is, what is 180 take away 52.11? 127.89. So 127.89 degrees. Okay, so let me write that down. Or, this is a second possibility that my calculator didn't tell me about. B could be about equal to 127.89 degrees. Now the question is this valid? Is there room for C? Well, let's see. I know that if B is 52.11, that implies, well, C is going to be what? Well, with this value of B, I'd get 180, take away the value of A that I have to consider, right? Take away 20, and then take away the 52.11. If I use that, I get a C of what? It would be 107.89. Okay, so that's certainly one possibility, right? C could certainly be 107.89. But if I use this value of B, the question now is there room for C? Let me check it out. Well, C would be 180, take away 20, take away this value of B, right? 127.89. And what would I get? Well, C would be 32.11. And what I see is that this is a possibility, right? There was enough left over for another value of C. In other words, we have two possibilities. If B is this, then C is that. But if B is this, then C is that. And that means I have to find the sides, a C for each of these different angles. So if, let me write this down. Let's do it for the B is, if B is equal to 52.11, what does that imply C has to be? Well, I can use the I can use my law of sines again, and that would imply that, let's see, sine of 20 divided by 13 is equal to, well, it would be sine of, I'm looking for little c, right? I already have little a and little b. Now, c was 107.89, so 107.89 divided by the little c. And if I solve this equation, just like I did before, cross multiply and then divide, I find that c is equal to 36.17, okay? So one possibility is this. B could be 52.11 degrees, and C could be 36.17, okay? But the second possibility arises when B is 127.89. So let's write, or, a second possibility. Or B is equal to 127.89, and of course that implies C is equal to 32.11, and these are degrees, these are angles, and that implies little c, right? Sine of 20 divided by 13 again is equal to sine of, well, now it's not 107.89, it would be 32.11 for C, right? These are degrees, divided by little c, and if I solve that equation, I'm gonna get C is equal to 20.20. Okay, so here's another possibility. These are my B and C angles, and there's my value of C. And by the way, I should have written, if this is B, right, 52.11, then the corresponding C is, let's write that down, 107. Let me just redraw that. 107.89 degrees. Okay, and if you're in that camp, right, this B and C, that implies little c is 36.17. But this camp implies with these values of C, you have a different value of C. And that's why there are two solutions, two triangles that'll work. So you can see why we call side-side angle the ambiguous case, because you can have one, two, and you can actually have no solutions. And that final case, which we haven't seen, consider this. So consider the situation, okay? And this is not this problem, but imagine you had a problem like this. You made it this far, and it said sine of B is 1.7. That's impossible, right? Sine of B is always less than one. It's never greater than one. So that would be impossible. In other words, sometimes you're given information and it leaves you with an impossible impossible situation, and in that case, there'd be no solution. Okay, so that's how you use law of sines, including the ambiguous case.